I greet you, dear brethren, in the mighty name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. How are you? I hope this Tuesday you are fine and the Lord has been with you. We want to glorify His name for this Father He has brought us. Today, I'd like to welcome you to our 100 Days of Prayer series, and today we are in day 75. I remember this according upon Jesus is our urgent need at this moment and very crucial need because of what is happening. And I would like you to welcome you. I'd like to welcome you so that we can continue with our study and our devotion so that Jehovah God can be glorified in our lives. Shall we pray as we begin? Our kind and loving Master, we invoke the Holy Presence to abide with us. As we read this word, may He interpret it for us. May you be with my dear viewer, bless him, and be with him, O Jehovah God, so that even as we partake of this word, that we will find a praise in our hearts. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. The focus of today comes from the book of Galatians 5:22-23, and the title or the theme is a reflection of Jesus's character. A reflection of Jesus's character. Remember, we have been looking at the importance of the Holy Spirit as a gift that we were given by Jesus Christ. Remember when He had that conversation with the disciples and He told them that I am going for you so that it will be on your, when I go, it will be on your advantage, because when He goes, He promised to send the Holy Spirit to dwell among them and to help them through their lives. And this is have been our topic, and we have been looking at the importance of the Holy Spirit and how the Holy Spirit works in our lives. Today's word comes from the book of Galatians 5 verse 22-23, and I will read from the New King James Version. The Bible says, but the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. Against such there is no law. When you accept the Holy Spirit into your life, and as you receive the Spirit of Christ, the Spirit of unselfish love and labor for others, you will grow and bring forth fruit. The graces of the Spirit will ripen in your character. Your faith will increase, your convictions deepen, your love be made perfect. More and more, you will reflect the likeness of Christ in all that is pure, noble, and lovely. This fruit can never perish, but will produce after its kind a harvest unto eternal life. The Spirit leads us to Jesus Christ. The moment we receive the Holy Spirit in our lives, He leads us to Jesus Christ. And as we abide in Jesus through a daily connection with the Holy Spirit, He will develop in us a character that reflects each day a little more the selfless, self-sacrificial, loving character of Jesus Christ. It is a transformational process of a lifetime. It is not just a one-day aspect. It is not just a one-week's aspect. It is not 3 months' aspect. No, it is a process of lifetime. Just like a mango does not appear an hour after the seed has been planted, but takes its time to grow into a tree that eventually bears fruits, so also the work of sanctification in a process is a process that takes time. But rest assured that through surrender and faithfulness, every aspect of the fruit of the Spirit will become evident in your life. Because as Christians, we are to show the fruits. The fruits have to come. The results of you being in Jesus Christ, the result of you having accepted Jesus or having accepted the Holy Spirit to work in you must be manifested. And this is, it takes time. And we remember the only purpose and reason why we are created or why we are called as Christians is to portray Christ in us. The question that I will ask to you today is that, have you let the Holy Spirit develop in you His fruit? Are there any fruits that are being seen in you? Are there some aspects of the fruit of the Holy Spirit which you have been resisting Him to work on? Because let me tell you, when the Holy Spirit is in you, there are many perspectives of life that you will be seeing. There are many things that will be demanded from you. There are many aspects that are expected of you to maybe lifestyle. In your lifestyle, there is a way that you should live. Ask yourself, or have a heart-searching experience, and ask yourself, are there any of these fruits that you have been resisting? Is it your desire to reflect Jesus more and more until all that people see is Jesus' character of love in you? Remember, when you become a Christian, you are someone who is transformed to be like Christ. And you are supposed to reflect who Christ is. You are supposed to have the character of Jesus Christ. Have you been reflecting the character of Christ to you? Have you been allowing the Holy Spirit to reflect Christ in your heart? If you have not been doing that, it is not late, my brother. It is not late, my sister. It is high time that you allow Jesus to come into your life. It is high time that you allow the power of Christ to dwell in your heart. Remember, if you don't have these fruits, the fruits that we have led today, it is high time that you accept the Holy Spirit to dwell in your heart. The fruits of love, the fruits of joy, the fruits of peace, the fruits of patience, the fruit of kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. Again, such things, you cannot be compatible to the will of God. You must be interim with these all things. And when you are in line with them, then you will be manifesting the Holy Spirit or the power of the Holy Spirit in your life. It is a high time that we ask Jesus to give us the Holy Spirit, because it is a free gift. And when He gives us, when we receive the Holy Spirit, I know we will have something to praise God for. We will have something to glorify God for, because He will be dwelling in our lives. May God bless you, my dear viewer, and may you find in your heart a time to allow the Holy Spirit to dwell in your heart. As we get into the session of prayer, if you have never accepted the Holy Spirit to work on you, if you have any resistance towards the work of the Holy Spirit, just confess, and God is gracious and He is willing to forgive you of all your iniquities, and you will start, you have a new life, and you will be able to do what is in accordance to the will of God. Shall we pray? Our kind and loving Master in heaven, we are thankful and grateful for the word that has come from thy scriptures. We invoke thy holy presence to abide with us, so that in us there will be manifest of the fruits of his fruits, O Jehovah God, so that we will live in accordance to thy will. I pray for my dear viewer, may you be with him or her. If Jehovah God, he has not accepted the Holy Spirit into his life, O Jehovah God, may you send that Spirit into him. And Jehovah God, if there are no fruits that are manifested from him, Jehovah God, it is a high time that Jehovah God, at this moment, that the fruits will be manifested for the glory and honor of your name. Thank you because you are faithful. Thank you because of this wonderful gift, beautiful gift that you have given unto us. And as we continue to near the cross of the world's history, we pray that may he, the Holy Spirit. Help us to be all, to build in us the character of Jesus Christ, so that we will be true Christians, ready to receive you when you to receive him when he comes the second time in the clouds. Thank you for listening unto us. Thank you for even answering our prayers, because we have been praying for you, to you, O Jehovah God, and you have been answering our prayers. May you be with my dear viewer. The needs that he has, may you accomplish them, and to Jehovah God, because you know them. The prayers he has posted before thy throne of grace, if they are in accordance to thy will, may you answer them according to your riches in glory. We have prayed this shortly, believing and trusting in that wonderful name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen and amen. May God bless you, may God keep you, and may he hide you under his wings, so that you will be safe. And even through this period of difficulty, this crisis of pandemic, may God protect you, and may God restore what you have lost. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you. Stay safe. God bless you.